Good evening, everyone, and welcome back to Frost Survival. So, we're out at Thicket Excavation again, which is still not drained, but such is life. And we're going to head... Just bring up my map. So we're going to head along down this way, past the Starlight Drive-In, and along this road, because there's a town, I think, about there. It has a hospital and a police station that I want to check for gear. Before we... Ooh. Hello? Well, that was... Oh, shit. Alright, then. Anybody else? No, it doesn't look like it. Okay, anyways, as I was saying, before I was so rudely interrupted by the meat delivery service and a ghoul, we're gonna go and save before we do that. Fortunately, there's a bed right here, right next to the now-deceased ghoul. Alright, there we go. So, to get where we're going, we need to go along this road and turn right. Oh shit! Oh! Alright. Any other ghouls around? That was, yeesh. Okay, maybe I should check this little block of stones here. Maybe there's some ghouls in there. I don't hear any, like, moving around or anything. I think maybe that one just was with the other one that was chasing the Radstag and just got separated from him, I guess? And so he ran in later. Yeah, I'm not hearing any, and I don't see any. No, I think it's fine. Alright. Back to our little journey. Huh. Found another iBot. Maybe it's the same one. What is this one saying?
Cambridge,
oh, there we go. Cambridge Polymer Labs. Oh! Oh, this is Brahmin. Brahmin, actually. Free meat? I do like free meat. Nah, I'll leave him for now. We'll get him on the way back. Oh! I heard a gunshot. Sounds like someone's fighting the mole rats again. I do not want to get involved in that. What is going on? Yep. Person over there. You're punching the mole rats? That is a bold strategy, friend. I don't know how that's going to work out for you. You're going quite well, actually. Well. Do we have any good equipment that I might want? Doesn't really look like it, and I'm assuming they're punching things because they've run out of bullets. No, don't lead them over here. Okay, they're dead. Well, joy. Freaking mole rats are still around. Alright, we're gonna have to stay low for this next bit, unfortunately. So I don't want to risk mole rats suddenly freaking appearing next to me and eating my leg. Okay, I think we're far enough away now. We should be fine. Oh. What is that? That sounds like a big gun. We're just near. Covenant is right down there. That might be their machine gun turrets, actually. Let's go check it out. I want to know what they're shooting at, mostly. Well, you know, I also want to know if it's actually Covenant with the machine gun turrets, because Covenant might be completely different. And the answer is... It's Covenant. Jesus, they're fighting a bunch of feral ghouls. Oh my god, there's a... Look at all those guards. Well... Let's not go near that, ever. Let's, avoid that like the plague, in fact. Oh, I'm stuck on some tires. Okay. So we're here. The town is not too far off, so we're almost there. Huh. Looks like the, that ambush trade caravan that comes from Covenant in, no Fallout 4 is still here. I wonder what kind of gear they've got on them. Oh. Well, and you have some grenades, I'll take. A gunner, sorry. Huh. I don't thought they'd exist here. Ooh, a combat rifle. I'll take the 45 rounds. I've already got a combat rifle back at home, so it's not really worth taking. I do kind of want those, but I don't have enough weight for them. I'd love them, because then I could scrap them and make pockets, but... Unfortunately, Can't open that. Cow meat, again, would be good, but don't have any space for it. Antiseptic I'll take. There's not much else there. Alright, maybe we can clear some space on the way back or something, I don't know. Well, presumably, we'll be doing the same thing that we did with the Super Duper Mart, where after we clear out the hospital, we'll come back and, you know, loot it for stuff, so it should still be here when we come back. Alright, so there's the hospital, I believe. I'm pretty sure. And usually, something angry outside it. Oh, we got... Uh-oh. I was expecting ghouls, but it looks like that's being guarded by... possibly bandits? It's hard to tell from this distance. They don't look like they're holding rifles, so I don't think they're, like, military remnants or anything, but... they're definitely armed. Okay. Well, I have my doubts that they're friendly. So I'm thinking... we might just start shooting. And let it, you know, sort itself out later. Okay, good. I have the grenades equipped. So, first, the dog. Now you. This is not reacting to this laser fire. There we go. And the other person doesn't seem to have noticed, but they will in a second. And there we go. Alright, I don't see anyone else rushing. Oh, no, never mind. I stand corrected. And just right about... God, it's hard to see where his head is in that armor. Okay, so there's one more over there at least. There. Oh, God, he's running around so much. There we go. Okay, anybody else? Doesn't seem to be. I don't see anyone else running towards me. I think we're alright. Yeah, alright. Let's go check out what kind of loot they had on them. Oh, again. That's a person. Oh, that's a person. Oh, that's a person who spotted me. Don't come near me with that ripper. Jesus. Malden man. What the fuck is that? Oh, because it's Malden Memorial Hospital, isn't it? Medford Memorial Hospital. What's a Malden, man? I want the Ripper, though. Also, man, that freaking demon mask. Jesus. What does that even do? Gives you luck. Interesting. Well, I want the Ripper. I'll have to... Jesus, that's heavy. I'll have to drop some stuff for it. Short pipe revolver rifle. There we go. That actually works out perfectly. Because Rippers are pretty good. They're low damage, but they hit really, really fast. Okay, so we've got some new faction guarding this place then. Someone that I had not encountered before. Whatever the hell a Malden man is. And there's a person over there that I should get rid of. Let me just get a better spot to shoot from. Right here should be good. Oh, hello. Oh, there are some dead ghouls here. Interesting. Stun grenade. A pole hook. What is that a weapon? That is a weapon. Stun grenade, arm bones, cage armor. Man, you guys are weird. What was that? Something exploded. Light dog armor, chain dog collar, mongrel dog meat. Alright, that's all neat. Something exploded over here. But what? The skeleton. Okay, so the question, I guess, is this place full of ghouls and the Malden men were just, like, clearing it out, or is it full of Malden men? What do you got? Pole hook, knuckles, mole rat teeth. They seem to be very melee-focused. They're also very well armored. Let's go check the last guy that was over here. There doesn't seem to be a whole lot of other people wandering around, although I do really want to know what exploded, because, you know, that seems like useful information. Oh, hey, it's a police station. Cool. We'll have to check that out at some point, because there might be stuff in there. I feel like we're less likely to find important things in the police station than we are in the hospital, though. What do you got? Remembering Zion. What? It's a note. More rat teeth, lead pipe, bunch of stuff. What is this note? Miss, Remembering Zion. By the rivers of Babylon there was sat down, yea, we wept when we remembered Zion. Okay, this is a poem. Fantastic. Poetic, angry, chainsaw wielding. Oh, murderers. Okay, there's a few more of them down there. They look to be dressed about the same, so I'm gonna assume those are also Malded men. And that maybe they have taken over this town, I guess? Who can say? Anyways, let's head inside. Hopefully not get murdered horribly. Alright. Head for Memorial Hospital. On the upside, if it's not ghouls, then I can take my gas mask off at least and have a bit better perception for what good that does me. But I guess we'll have to see. It could be both, actually. They could be fighting each other in there. Alright, what we got? A lot of blood. That is a lot of blood. Meatbag. Meatbag. No people, though. Which is, you know, a little bit... What was that noise? That's, that doesn't sound like a good noise, I have to be honest. I really, really hope that's someone, like, revving a ripper or something, and not, like, a deathclaw. Oh, fuck. Man, this 44 is great. I'm running out of ammo for it. Come on. Ah, fuck. There we go. Jesus. Okay, I definitely heard another person talking. Which does kind of imply there's not a Deathclaw around here, because I feel like it would have, you know, killed everybody. I'm glad these people carry so many bones. I've always thought people don't carry around enough human bones on their person. Let's check out the ground floor before we go any higher. Be a little bit more careful so as not to get, you know, chomped by random people. Okay. On the upside, they definitely seem to be very, very melee-focused, which is good for me, because I am not very, very melee-focused. And I am quite happy to not have a fair fight with people. I hear footsteps. Got an elevator. Oh, that's someone walking above me. Okay, that freaked me out. Oh, hello. I think there was a third person in there. There's definitely someone with the... Oh. Someone with a ripper upstairs. But it doesn't sound like they're coming down. So we're okay for now. Cripes, this place is grim. Knuckles, switchblade, bunch of armor. Crack glass bowl. What was that? I was talking. Oh, you. Bandages. I love bandages. I should use a bandage, actually. I have taken a little bit of damage. Got bit by that dog. Ooh, empty bottle. Yes. Give me that. You're dead. Some drugs. Other stuff. I got a board game sitting on top of a trash can. Are those empty bottles? No, those are blood packs. Well, blood packs are nice. And this is a kitchen, and it's full of meat. That is just great. Just great. Full of meat and human bones. Just what I want in my kitchens. Oh, I made a mistake coming here. Rib cage. Alright, what do you got? Meat hook, mole rat teeth. So basically they all have a melee weapon, some bones, and a bunch of heavy armor on them, is what I'm getting. Good. Good. Okay, that's the elevator. What is further along this way? There's a door, which I suspect goes back out into the main room that we were just in. I was right. Okay, so that's that little wing of the ground floor clear. About over here. There's another door there. I really need a better handgun. Like, the 44 is great, it's just that I don't have any ammo for it. Medical liquid nitrogen dispenser. Wow. That's nice. Bone cutter. Some other junk. Okay. Long, dark hallway. Good. My favorite. Turn the light off. For a second, so I can be a little bit more sneaky here. And what is in this room? The door's closed. What is in this room? Bunks and bags of meat and a really, really poorly equipped enemy. This is why ranged weapons are good. Even really slow firing ones. Broken femur. It's empty. I could unlock it. Hunting rifle. Oh, I love hunting rifles. Oh, it's so heavy though. Also, I hear footsteps. You got. They really like stun grenades, which I'm assuming means they try and take people alive. Which is not actually a very comforting thought. Okay, I don't think he's coming in here. What else you got? Bunch of heavy armor, demon mask again. Some stuff. Alright, we'll come back for the hunting rifle. I'll grab it when we come back to actually, like, loot this place properly. Okay. Nope, no one there. I think they're upstairs. Unfortunately, the footsteps from upstairs transfer very well to downstairs, so it's hard to tell. Anybody in here? Nope. There, just close the door behind me. Make sure no one walks in without me noticing. There is a terminal, which is locked, and I don't think I can unlock. Nope. Okay. Oh, wait, was that an empty bottle? Oh, no, it's just vodka. And there's a generator, so there's a fusion core in here somewhere, which is good. Good thing to have. Okay. Empty. Empty. God, it's getting dark. Okay, I really don't want to turn the light on. As much as I like being able to see, I also like not being immediately spotted by angry people with chainsaws. Well, this seems to be the ground floor empty. So let's go check upstairs, I suppose. Oh. Okay, that's all blocked off. Well. How about we travel along a little bit then? So we go back to the main room. I know there's a way upstairs, and I hope all the doors upstairs aren't blocked, because that would be really kind of irritating. Although I guess going up further doesn't really cost me anything. But I definitely hear people walking around, like, directly upstairs. So I know there's some way to get up to the second floor from here. Just make sure there's no, you know, enemies wandering around up there. Maybe there's not. You know, that does actually look fairly blocked off now that I look at it from down here. Maybe there's something on this side, though. Yeah, there's a doorway here that looks openable, at least. Let's go check it. What is she wearing? Oh, she's got face paint on. Okay. I thought she was wearing some, like, really funky skull mask. That door actually looks openable, too, now that I look at it. No one down there. And I don't see anyone in there. What about in here? I definitely heard someone walking around up here earlier. And I can still hear someone walking around up here. And it's not me. Okay, so far so good. What are these? I wish I could. Where's these plaques at? Oh, they're bathrooms. Good. Great. Bathrooms. Bathrooms occasionally have medical supplies in them, but these ones don't. Oh, wait, no, they do. Oh, the door's, like, super blocked. Holy shit. Oh my god, I want all of this stuff. Okay, I'm gonna need to ditch some some stuff for this. Yeah, two knuckles I don't need. Give me all of the bandages. Give me all of the stim packs. Surgical kits. Damn it. Okay, I need to ditch something else. Well, should be carrying some junk I can get rid of. Gold watch I probably don't need. Coffee cup I definitely don't need. And exchange. Yes. Oh, that's good. Alright, we'll come back for the rest of the stuff, because I don't need that immediately, but... Oh, that was such a good find. Okay, lights out again. Some folders. Nada. Okay, nobody. Is there anything back here? Not really. All terminals look dead as well. A little bell I could ring, maybe. Oh! Hello, friend. These guys are really, like, spread out. Okay, somebody walking around upstairs again. Oh, shit, that's a big open space. I don't want to go out there because people from upstairs might spot me. What do you got? Not a lot. Okay, just stay in the shadows. Oh. Oh, there's a friend. Come on, come around the corner. No? Come on, man, I know you're there. Oh, there you are. And... bang! And, wow, this room is surprisingly clean. I mean, okay, ignore the rubble pile in the corner. Look, beds. Nice, neat beds. Got anything up there that I can see? Oh, yeah, there we go. Well, you are in an unlucky spot, my friend. As for your pal, who's over there, now thoroughly confused. Oh, yeah, just stay right there. Thank you. You guys are not great at security, if I'm 100% honest. But there you go. So it's just one of the downsides to being a lunatic cannibal. Don't always think your plans through all the way. I mean, I don't always think my plans through all the way either, but at least I have morality on my side. Justice and whatnot. So there's a staircase over there, but I don't want to go up just yet. It's usually good practice to clear out the bottom floors first. So there's less risk of getting cut off if you need to go back down. Lights out. Anybody? Oop. Shit. Ow. Ow. Okay, I'm... Jesus. Well, on the upside, I've got a bunch of surgical kits. So that's good. And we can use a blood pack and a bandage. That'll get me most of the way back to full. Nice. And also, this guy dropped a journal. Am I out of bullets for the 44 yet? I have one. I have one bullet left. Tarius the Wise's journal. Okay, I'll take that. So reload my laser musket. Quick read of this. Tarius the Wise's journal. Meldon was a wicked place. Scientists performed foul tests on unwilling patients, and parents watched as their children transformed into cogs of the great machine. For these crimes, Ugh Qualtoth sent us the Angel. She is to purify Maldon of its cursed past. She is to teach us the way of the new world, and she will not rest until the crimes of the past are erased completely. Elder Atreus has called a council meeting to discuss the issue of the old world ghosts. They block our path to the Holy Chapel and disrupt our operations at Dunwich. If only the Angel could be sent against them, but the voice tells us that this is not the way of things. We must use the strength of our own arms in this battle. I do not fear the war to come, for it has all been done before. Okay, interesting. So they're from Dunwich. Do I have Dunwich on my map? I know vaguely where it is. It's like... I'm gonna say it's here-ish? Maybe? I could be wrong about that. But that's interesting. Alright, so these guys are from an area then. These guys are from somewhere specific that I'll have to go check out at some point. Okay, we found the elevator shaft. That's good. So I guess that elevator doesn't work then. And Okay, we're just back to the second floor now. Oh, there's another half to check. But I think this is probably a good place to stop for the moment. So next time we will... That looks to be the top floor, so we'll clear out the top floor of this hospital and see what else we can find. So, thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next episode. Goodbye.